Today I want to re-record a 4-year-old video on dynamically growing arrays. The basic idea is arrays in C have a fixed size that must be known at compile time. And if that doesn't work for you, you can use pointers to have dynamically growing arrays that fit your runtime needs. Okay, so let's immediately jump into the program and I will explain what we see here. So on line 15, we just declared a vector called squares, which you can see here. A vector consists of a data array with 3 elements and a used variable that says how many of those elements are currently in use. Okay, and we should probably initialize the used variable to 0, and that's what the init function is for. So we call the init function, which takes a pointer to a vector, and we pass a pointer to squares. So here you can see that self indeed points to squares. Okay, and now we can initialize the used variable via the self pointer. So this line will assign 0 to the used variable. Here you can see it. Okay, cool. Now we have a for loop. The purpose of this loop is to fill the vector with all the squares up to and including 10, which shouldn't be too many. So let's see. The first time we call it, again, we pass a pointer to squares, so self will point to squares. You can see it, self points to squares. And now we have the magical line 11. What does it do? It says, I want to access the data array at index 0, right? That would be here. And I want to store the value, which is 1 in our case, the first square number, basically. So 1 will be stored at index 0, which is here. And then the used counter will be incremented from 0 to 1. So we would expect a 1 in both places here. And that's indeed what happens. Maybe let's do it a second time. So what's now the case? We want to store the value 4 at the index 1, which would be here. So we expect a 4 here. And then used will be incremented from 1 to 2. There we go. Okay, let's do it a third time. So we call it again. What do we want to do? Value 9 should be stored at index 2, which is here. So we expect a 9 over here. And then used will be incremented from 2 to 3. There we go. Okay, and then the for loop will stop because 16 is bigger than 10. And then the program terminates. Okay, so we were lucky, 3 was big enough. Now what happens if I increase the 10 to 100, start the program again and say step return, which will run main to completion, then it says index 3 out of bounds 3. That happened because here in line 11, we try to store the value 16 at index 3. But in an array of size 3, there is no index 3, right? We only have the indices 0, 1, and 2 in an array of size 3. So that's basically a buffer overflow. And in normal C systems, anything can happen from now on. But my little IDE detects this bug. Okay. Of course, now we could choose a different number here. For example, 10 would be big enough for this use case. But the point is, in general, we can't always know in advance how big our arrays should be. These numbers could come from the hard drive, from user input, from a database, from the network. And we should be able to grow that array as our needs grow at runtime. Okay, but we can't do that with these ordinary C arrays. Instead, we have to say we want a pointer to the first element of an array, which we have to allocate ourselves. And we have to remember how big that array is. Okay, so how will we do this? Let me show you. So first we initialize the size to 3 just as before. And then we have to allocate from the heap, memory from the heap. How much do we need? We need the size multiplied by size of the element type. Okay, so in our case, that would be 3 times 4, 12 bytes. Okay, and if we start this program and push step return, we will see the same error message because we don't grow that array anywhere yet. But you can see already the difference in the data layout. So first, we had the array in place inside the squares directly. And now we only have a pointer to the first element of an array that was allocated on the heap via malloc. So it makes a huge difference if you write data is a pointer or data is an array. Some people will tell you that arrays are pointers. That's complete nonsense. As you can see here, it's clearly a very different memory layout. Okay, but surprisingly, line 14 didn't change at all. So the syntax for accessing an array directly or indirectly is exactly the same. And that's probably why people tend to confuse arrays with pointers. Okay, cool. So how could we detect this error? So how could we detect that this line will basically cause this error? That's quite simple. We simply have to check these two values. If size and used are the same, then that means that the array is completely populated and we should probably make it bigger. Okay, so let's simply check for that. So if the size and the use count are exactly the same or are equal, in our case 3, then we have to do two things. We have to increase that number from 3 to 6, for example. Let's simply double the number. And after we have changed this integer, we have to make this array bigger. Okay, so the size, we can simply add the size to itself. That would double it without doubt. And then we can say data should be reallocated. Here is the old array, and here is the new size in bytes. Okay, so that should already give us some interesting runtime behavior. Let's see. So maybe let's first fill the array up. Let's store 3 squares inside. And then let's see what happens if we jump into the add function. So here we notice that 3 and 3 are equal. So we jump to the next line. Then we increase the size from 3 to 6 right here. And now we make the array bigger. Okay, if we do the realloc, we can see now we have space for 6 elements instead of 3. So the 16 has enough space. Okay, so maybe let's put some more numbers in, 25. And 36. And now we have a similar situation. We notice that 6 and 6 are the same. So we say we have to increase 6 to 12. And then we have to reallocate to make more space. And now we have space for up to 12 elements. Okay. So here the 49 has enough space. And if I run the program to completion, you can see we filled up to index 9 where the 100 was stored. And we didn't really need the last two elements, but we couldn't have known that beforehand in general. Okay, you forgot to free one heap blocks. So there's a general rule that says memory that was allocated via malloc and reallocated via realloc has to be freed explicitly by the programmer because C has no garbage collection. Okay, so we could simply say, okay, we are done using the array. Let's simply say free squares.data. That would work. Let me quickly show you that the error message is now gone and the array was freed. But that's not really good style because the malloc was encapsulated in the init function, as you can see here. So let's also encapsulate the call to free in its own function. So maybe let's say, let's write a destructor, if you will, for squares. Or for vectors in general. Let's write it here. So let's call it done. Struct vector self, and then it frees. So I have still in the clipboard the data indirectly through the this pointer, the self pointer. Right? That works as well. Okay. And that's basically all there is to it. Right? So maybe a quick recap. If you want an array that can grow dynamically at runtime, you can't declare the array as an array. You have to declare a pointer instead. And that pointer will point to memory on the heap if you allocate via malloc. Then via realloc, you can make the array bigger. And when you're done, you have to release the memory via free. Otherwise, you have a memory leak. Okay. And if you peek into the implementation of C++'s standard vector or Java util array list, you will see a similar concept, right? So basically every array that has the capacity to grow dynamically will do something like this in most languages at least. Okay, and we also used pointers for the self pointer. Maybe a little homework for you, get rid of those pointers. So say you want to pass by value instead of by pointer, if you will, and see how the program behaves differently and why we really need that pointer to simulate object-oriented programming in C. Okay, that's all for today. See you next time.